Hi guys. So we are, I do believe this is week five. And so we have done a lot so far. I hope you are practicing the You Say video. I would love to somehow get together and just kind of go over it with you guys and just practice it. So, last lesson, we talked about sentences, and we learned some sentences here. So, we're going to do some review. So, this is a quiz for you, so answer down below. I'm just going to ask a couple of things, maybe about five sentences. I'm going to mark them. Okay. You ready? First one. I'm going to do it again. Okay. The second one is, and I did my eyebrow wrong. Okay. Okay, and that's the third one. Fourth one. Okay, and the last one. Okay, so five answers is what I'm looking for. So, I have divided my sections from ASL1 and ASL2, and we're almost done with ASL1, so we'll get into a little bit of ASL2 on the last couple videos, so that'll be fun. All right, so today, we're going to learn a few words that we're going to be using in some sentences. And some of these words we have already done. All right, so future. Whenever we talk about future, we're going to do this. This is will, and it's also future. Okay? And then before or in the past, we just flip our hands in the back. A little bit more straighter than mine, because mine does not go straight. Past. So this is the future. This is already done. Okay? Sometimes when we say we past did, we also can do we finished did. That can also be the past. All right. And so today is like now. This is now. This is supposed to be straighter. So make sure it's straighter like this. But even straighter than this. Flatter, I mean. So this is now. And if we would do today, we would go like this. Today. Look twice, small twice, today. That's today. And then finish, I already did that. Finish, all done. You can almost do past and finished together, not together, but it can mean almost the same thing. So those are like the verb tense, like the past tense, the future tense, the present tense. Present tense, you'll just do the verb. Okay. So, hot, we've done that one. Cold, okay? And then we have clothes. We're going to talk about some clothes. Clothes. If you go like this, clothes. If you do this, this is a shirt. Pants is when you go like this. Pants. Socks. Socks. Shoes. And coat. Coat is like you're putting it on. Coat. Or jacket. Jacket, coat, whatever. All right, so let's do that again. Clothes. Shirt. Pants. Socks. You're doing this. Socks. Shoes. And coat. That's just the main. Okay. And then we're going to learn some health words. health. This is body. Put an H, health. So we have wash. But if you're going to, you know, you wash your hand, you could wash your hand or take a bath, wash your face. Okay. Hurt. We've learned that one already. Hurt. Headache, tummy ache. Bathroom, T for toilet. This is an old way of doing it. Restroom. You may see some older deaf folks using it, but this is what's used more now. So if I have to go to bathroom, I'm going to go toilet. Okay. Brush teeth. You can do this or you can do this. Brush teeth or, okay. Sleep. Guys, I've already done this. Sleep. We did Silent Night. Sleep. I thought there was one other song that we used that for. And we did Nice and Clean the last time. These are words that we're going to be using in the sentences in a bit. Okay. Here's some requests kind of words. Like, please. Excuse me. Thank you. Help. Stop. Okay? Please. Excuse me. Thank you. Help. And stop. So, if you would say excuse me to a deaf person and she's in front of you, and you just do this, and she's facing the other way, is that going to do anything? No. You need to tap gently, and it's okay to tap them even in social distancing, if you're talking to a deaf person, it's the way it is. Just tap and then say, excuse me. Okay. And then let's, the big, you could do tall like this, T up, or you could do this. This is, you know, more current ASL. You could do tall or tall. All right, full. And the song we're doing, you say, this is enough, this is full. Forward twice for enough, this way towards you is full. Now, if you're talking about you're full and like you had enough to eat, you're doing this, full, okay? Full. Okay. And more. All right, so we're going to do some sentences. I love my family. So I'm going to sign those words like it would be if it was straight English. Our English grammar would be, I love my family. All right, and you guys should know all of the, I just lost the book. You guys should know all of those signs. But the first thing is time, topic, and comment. What about the topic? Okay, so now we don't have the time in this one. So it's the topic. Topic is family. So it would be family, I love. Okay, so family, I love. All right, the second sentence would be, my dad likes cold pizza. So what's the topic? It's cold pizza. So cold pizza. Another sign for pizza is pizza. So we could do cold pizza, my dad likes. Okay. So the subject is cold, topic is cold pizza, and then my dad likes. Okay. All right. My mom likes church. Topic, church. My mom likes. Okay. I hope you are finding as I'm teaching, because the more you copy me, the more you're going to learn. Okay. All right. He likes hot dogs. What's the topic? Hot dogs. Hot dogs. He likes. She wants food. Food is the topic. Food she wants. My brother likes hot bath. I wonder if you guys remember the sign for brother. Okay, so it would be hot bath is the topic. Hot bath, my brother likes. Let's do that again. Hot bath, my brother likes. Okay, my sister likes school. School is a topic. School, my sister likes. My grandma have green coat. Talking about the green coat. Green coat, my grandma have. This is have. Okay, so green coat, my grandma have. All right, so last year, my grandpa work. Talking about your grandpa working. Okay, so last, this is the past, and the time is first. Last year, so it kind of goes with the sentence anyway, my grandpa worked. So it stays here. The same as the sentence. She is a happy baby. Happy baby is the topic. Happy baby, she. Happy baby. Okay. I finished my homework. Homework, finish. Homework, finish. I drive to school. So school, I drive. Okay. School, I drive. And it doesn't make sense in our grammar, because we're thinking we're driving to school. No, we're driving to school, but that's what's understood in ASL grammar. Okay. I go to the store. Store, I go. Store, I go. It could also be, store, go I. And that had, it can go both ways. Okay, I went to church with my husband. So we're talking about going to church, and went is the past. So it would be church, time first. Actually, no, because it's not really talking about time, sorry. So I went, church, I passed go with husband. Church, I passed go with husband. Last week I sleep in my car. That's the time, time at first. Last week, car, I sleep. Okay, last night, cold outside. All right, so those are all the sentences that I have for this lesson. And so I like to see some of you guys come up with sentences. Just remember, time is first. If you can get a time in there, do it first. And we have gone through money and time and stuff like that, so you should know the sign for that. So time, topic, and then what about the topic? Okay, so I would like to see some sentences. That would be wonderful if I could see somebody give me a video of you coming up with your own sentences. Okay, that's the end of this. See you next time.